also didn't understand that even if I had backyard chickens that I was giving hugs and kisses to and they were laying me golden eggs, that these animals and their byproducts were not mine. Whatever skill set I can provide to help propel the vegan movement forward, that is my purpose, and right now it is health and fitness. I didn't understand what was really going on in these industries. I would only buy eggs and free-range chicken from a local organic farmer. I would hunt down the best brands of organic whole-fat milks and yogurts and pour hours of research into finding what the most healthful and organic products and brands out there were. I became an ethical vegan in May of 2015. It was viewing slaughterhouse footage that did it. I stumbled across an early Vegan Gains video that had a clip from Earthlings in it showing a cow being slaughtered. And before that point, I had always avoided watching any type of slaughterhouse footage because it's disgusting and it's very disturbing. And after that, I was like, that's it, I'm done. Next day. I work in the fitness industry, so figuring out what was going to work for me in dietary terms was probably the most challenging part, but it did not take very long to figure out. I've eaten pretty healthy my entire life, lots of vegetables, beans, lentils, so it really wasn't that difficult for me to switch over. I just eliminated the animal products and replaced them with more plant foods. It's crucial to teach ethics along with the nutrition, because if all you're doing is following a plant-based diet, you can very easily toss that diet aside because it's against the social norm. It takes effort. You're faced with animal products in social situations or just going out to the grocery store. So it's really important to understand the philosophy behind why you're leading a vegan lifestyle. Bicep shot.